Across America, there's a game enjoyed by many. Within college campuses, big or small, students face off against each other in the ultimate test of skill, accuracy, and sobriety. Most commonly found in tailgates or massive frat parties, the game of beer pong is played not only for entertainment, but to celebrate the spirit of healthy competition. Even famous celebrities and athletes have been seen joining in on the fun. Legends such as Michael Jordan, Betty White, and even Ole Honest Abe have been known to knock down a few red solo cups. In this video, we will explore the varying techniques and methods on how to approach the game of beer pong through physics. Why might you ask? Well, because science rules. There are three different types of shots in beer pong: the arc shot, the fastball, and the bounce shot. The first we shall look at is the arc shot. This shot is characterized by its large maximum height. This large peak results in a large angle of entry, which is optimal for the ball to enter the cup. To obtain this large maximum height, there must be a large change in height from the release point to the peak, which is achieved through having a large velocity in the vertical direction by applying the initial throwing force in a greater angle. Due to the forces of gravity, the velocity in the y direction accelerates negatively, while the velocity in the x direction remains the same. By using the equation v final of y squared equals v peak of squared plus 2g delta y, it can be found that the final velocity in the y direction is proportional to the change in height. With the angle of entry corresponding to the velocity in the y direction over the velocity in the x direction, as the change in height increases, the angle of entry increases as well. The next type of shot is the fastball. This shot is characterized by its large x velocity and small release angle. This shot results in a poor angle of entry, which is due to its low peak height. The fastball, while not being ideal, is beneficial when playing outdoors in a crosswind. With a shorter flight time than the arc shot, the fastball is affected less intensely by external forces. It can also be used when trying to knock back cups off of the table due to its large velocity in the x direction. The last shot is the bounce shot. Like the fastball, this shot has a larger x velocity than y, resulting from a smaller angle of release. However, in the case of the bounce shot, there's a topspin placed on the ball. This topspin creates a difference in air pressures between the top and the bottom of the ping pong ball, with a lower air pressure below the ball, resulting from faster moving air. The magnet's force pushes down on the ball, increasing the y velocity. Upon contact with the table, the conservation of momentum comes into play. In this perfectly elastic reaction, the extremely small mass ball comes into contact with the large table, which is at rest. The resulting velocity of the ball is roughly the same as it was prior to impact, but it was in the opposite direction. The ball still maintains its initial rotation, with similar magnet force. After the ball reaches its second peak, there is a large acceleration in the negative y direction, resulting from the magnets and gravitational forces. The acceleration causes a large change in vertical velocity, which causes an optimal angle for entry. Well, that's it for this video. Hopefully it helps you the next time you try to run a table. Good luck!